I wish, mostly because even though the length of the shoe is great, I think that they can hone in a little bit of the fit through the heel pocket. It just, a little. There we go, the Puma Liberate, okay? Puma, not messing around. I think they're onto something with this shoe and in their entire lineup that we've seen in 2021. I should probably do a Puma running shoe matrix for 2021. We'll see if we can squeeze that in before the end of the year. Here we go, diving in. It's a neutral road running shoe. All right, let's do the twist test. Whoa, loosey goose, flock of geese flying across the screen. It's unbelievable. Whoa, I mean, it might be the most loose. I'm trying to think, a Skechers shoe might, oh my, it is very, very loose. So what does that mean? Strong ankles, strong feet. You can't run in this shoe unless you have strong ankles and strong feet, which is one of the reasons I did take it, yes, to 37 miles, but I'm stopping. I'm not gonna go to 50. There's just, it's not because I dislike the shoe, it's just there's so many shoes to test, so 37 miles is where I'm stopping, but I definitely felt like I had to be in control of my foot strike. The shoe was not in control of me, okay? So let's dive into it. 10 millimeter drop from heel to toe. All right, 28 in the heel, 18 in the forefoot, so a leaner stack height. But it doesn't feel like there's a little bit of ground contact feel, but it's not overabundant, okay? I think I didn't feel like I was pounding the pavement too hard out there, even though it was a leaner stack height, especially under the forefoot. Women's size 8, men's size 9 on your screen. And in my size, I do believe it is epic. Coming in at, we're gonna call it, I'm gonna say 6 ounces, let's see. Yeah, 5.96 out loud, just epic. Great job, Puma, very great. Oh, 8.5 for my score. For the weight, for a neutral road running shoe, that's about as light as you're gonna find out there on the market. We're looking at a mono mesh, Skechers-esque. If you're a Skechers fan, you wear Skechers running shoes, it feels a little bit like Skechers through the upper, just so you're aware, that mono mesh there, okay? You would think it'd be very breathable, but I actually am gonna say no, it's not incredibly breathable through that upper. It is fully gusseted, which I love. Now, this is another, I hate to say, but Skechers-esque heel counter, okay? I mean, it's just like boing, boing, boing. There's no rigidity, no strength there. So the lockdown, not actually because of the tongue. The tongue laid on top of the foot really well. It is this collar and this heel counter. I don't know. Oh, I'm actually not afraid of the movement there in the heel counter. It's more, see how it's just kind of wavy there? There's just needs a little more uniformity, which I realize would probably bump the weight of the shoe up a little bit. So yeah, give and take in the running shoe design space, I fully realize. Overall score for the upper, 7 out of 10. I think that mono mesh, I don't think it's gonna wear out on you. It does feel very well built, like good construction, build quality. Also the eyelet chain. Reinforced eyelet chain combined with these laces, I like it. They're laying on top of the foot really nicely there through that eyelet chain. We're looking at their nitro midsole material. It's a super critical, yes, nitrogen infused midsole. And yes, it is the same super critical foam that Puma is using in their other midsoles as well. Oh, this durometer, it is soft, but it's, so you know, the Rebel V2, one of my favorites, maybe too soft in 2021, this might be the right durometer. It's like, Ooh, it's nice. That's one of the reasons I love this show. I'm a little sad. I might take it to 50 miles, actually. By the time you watch this, who knows? I'll let you know if I do take it to 50. I'm not running quite as much right now, which is also another reason it's hard to get the shoes to 50, but man, that midsole gets me excited to possibly take it out for more rides. But the ride and energy, we're keeping it at 7.5 out of 10. Overall score, 6.5 drops down because of the durability. I don't think it's gonna last forever. It's that Puma grip on the outsole. Overall, very pleased. I think high durability and grip. Great grip. I mean, just it feels really tacky to the touch, and so I think it's going to do well in wet conditions. And yes, of course, the outsole is not completely plastered with rubber, and a little bit of a decoupled groove starting there. Let's maybe enhance that in 2022 moving forward. Okay, on to the fit, true to size. I went 6 out of 10 because I wish, mostly because even though the length of the shoe is great, I think that they can hone in a little bit of the fit through the heel pocket. It just, it needs a cleanup on aisle heel counter, okay, here in the back of the shoe. That is for sure. Comfort score is 7 out of 10. Positive and drawback, positive. You can't really, for me, which is why it's a you can't relax in this shoe, all right? It forces you to think about your foot strike, to be on your A game, so you're not, you know, but if you wanna just zone out and just go for a run, it's probably not the shoe for you. But this shoe, it forced me to really focus on getting up on my toes, which I love. I love running on my toes now. It was about a 2-year transition to more so. I'm not 100% forefoot. I'm more midfoot to forefoot, probably, you know, if you really look at my gait cycle, but I think most people are. But I do, I just do love getting up on my forefoot, which this shoe forces you to do. Collar is the drawback, of course. How will I use this shoe? Short tempo runs or days to work on foot strike, 3 to 6 mile distance. Who is it best for? You gotta be in control of your foot strike, all right? Price point, $110. Are you kidding me? Come on now, Puma. That's what I'm, $110, that, they just nailed it. $110, that's a great price point, I think, for this shoe. I would even pay $120 probably for the Puma Liberate. Other shoes to buy. So, you know, not a lot of people are familiar with Puma, so you might not, you know, but this is where I'm putting it into this category of shoes. So the Skechers Speed Freak, the Under Armour Flow Velocity, New Balance Rebel V2, and the Reebok Float Ride Run Fast 3.0. That's the cousin to the Puma Liberate. Just kind of loosey-goosey, lean, lower stack heights, and not a lot of upper action. You know, if you love a solid, it's not like the opposite of Asics, the opposite of Mizuno, as far as the upper build quality is concerned. But there you have it, all right. Shoe quick specs for the Puma Liberate. One more time, 10 millimeter drop, women's size 8, men's size 9, or sorry, my size, 6 ounces, 170 grams, mono mesh upper, Puma grip rubber on that outsole. And the relegation score, 7.1 out of 10. I wish I could get it to 50, and again, I might do it just for fun here in the next 4 or 5 days. Sean, you get the comment of the day. Sean says, I've run in a lot of top shoes of 2020 and 2021, and I keep coming back to the Asics Nova Blast 2. It's been such a solid trainer. I feel confident in its versatility and protection underfoot, and the energy return is, in my opinion, the best out there for a non-plated daily trainer. Sean, cheers to you. I couldn't agree more. Nova Blast is right up there. Actually, that's what we're gonna toss it back to here in a second. Hold on, one sip. That's what we're gonna toss it to here in a second, Sean. The top three running shoes of 2021 for me. But first, that question of the day. What running website did you visit last? And did you find what you were looking for? You know, whether it was a race result, whether it was a running shoe, whether it was a course preview, whether it was something about nutrition, whatever the case may be, I must say, race websites, I'm like, ooh, there's a market there to improve race websites. Oh man, after researching Rotterdam and trying to find a good marathon for the spring 2022, whew, someday on DeMoorGlobalRunning.com, you better believe it. All right, everyone, have a great day. We will toss it to my top three running shoes of 2021 Right there, right there, right there. All right, seek beauty, work hard, and love each other. See you tomorrow.